Okay.
Hello, welcome. My name's Dr Anthony Cox. I'm the head of education for the undergraduate pharmacy program at the University of Birmingham. And I'm a reader in clinical pharmacy and drug safety, which is my area of research. So I'm going to talk today about what pharmacy is like at the University of Birmingham. So why be a pharmacist? Why study at Birmingham to be a pharmacist? And what are the admission criteria to do pharmacy? So I'll just take you through those as we talk about the program. So pharmacists are the experts in medicine. There isn't another profession that does as much about medicines as pharmacists. We do how they work, how you make them, how you make a chemical into a medicine, and how it's used in society and in individual patients to get good outcomes. And pharmacists have a commitment to improving people's lives through the use of medicines. And it's all about applying the science that you learn at university, as well as the clinical skills you use, to the development and use of those medicines in society. And perhaps in the past 3 months have been one of the times where it's been really clear how big a role pharmacists have in that, and be it from supply of drugs to patients through to the running of clinical trials. So we do a lot of work on individual medicines use and care of patients as well on this course. So it's, although it's a scientific course, it's also a caring profession, and that's one of the key attributes of pharmacy in terms of that meld of pharmaceutical knowledge and caring. So pharmacists have many roles. So one that most people are familiar with is community pharmacists that have been in the news a lot recently because of the massive workload they've been under as people topped up on medicines during the COVID outbreak. And so that's one of the major areas of pharmacy, but also pharmacists work in hospital pharmacies, supplying medicines within pharmacies and working within clinical teams to provide good patient care. For example, expert pharmacists working in ITU scenarios, dealing with COVID patients and et cetera, they've been just as frontline as many others. So pharmacists have those two major areas of sector of working that they do, but also they work in GP surgeries, increasingly dealing with patients with multiple disease states who take lots of medicines that all have the potential to interact, and also in walk-in centres for the NHS. But also they're involved in the pharmaceutical industry, and that could be in manufacturing of medicines, in the development of medicines, even marketing of medicines, but also clinical trials and drug safety monitoring of these drugs as they go into the market. There are also pharmacists that work in the military, branches of the military, and also within universities, either in a research or teaching capacity. Some pharmacists can become consultant pharmacists. So one of our academic members of staff is also a consultant pharmacist at the local hospital, and he runs oncology clinics and changes doses of drugs and sees patients in a clinic. So, and that part of that role is being an independent prescriber. So pharmacists are increasingly becoming prescribers, making decisions about what drugs are started and stopped within patients. So it's a really interesting role with lots of possible ways you could go forward in your career. So pharmacists have had increasing prominence over the past few months, but it's really been going on for the past 5 or 10 years. The role of clinical pharmacists within all branches of the profession has increased massively. So the lady on the right is actually one of our ex-students from graduated last summer, who's in a pre-registration year, and who's been working throughout the COVID crisis, and actually has had to step up to an increasing level of responsibility, perhaps more than would have normally happened. So it's been a great period of change, and it's just really exciting to see our students in these roles. And the Secretary of State for Health has really highlighted the role of pharmacists, as has the Prime Minister as well. But really it's an evolving role of pharmacists, getting into more clinical roles that are much more upfront. And that's partly why we built our pharmacy course to address this, and why we believe our MPharm is special. So we're based at a Russell Group University. We have nursing, medicine, dentistry, physiotherapy. We have all those other professionals within the college that the School of Pharmacy is part of, that allows us to provide really good integrated healthcare courses, where we have integrated interprofessional learning, either on placement or in the classroom. So we have sessions with dentists, physiotherapists, medicine and nursing students, to try and really get what pharmacists learn into the other, get them to work with other professions. And it really helps all the professions, because when they leave, they have a better understanding of all the different roles they all have. And therefore, it just makes them more effective and gives them that bit more confidence going forward in their careers. We're also in one of the largest healthcare regions in the UK, which enables us to provide good placements and really good experience. We have world ranking teaching and research, supported by pharmaceutical and medical science global experts who practice and are practicing now. And we have a greater patient focus, and that's what we designed into our program. So we have lots of simulated patients, clinical skills, patient facing teaching. We have a greater focus on placements as well, and bringing that experiential learning. So you get to meet a dialysis patient, and then you get to give a case talk about that patient and about what drugs they were on, etc. So that's key. So it's very much applied science in a clinical setting. And that's not to say that our students don't go on to do bench science PhDs. We have two students now, currently ex-students, who are now doing PhDs in lab-based science as well. So we do teach science, but there is an increase in clinical focus as the profession requires. So the MPharm structure for the four-year home course that we run, pharmacy is a four-year degree that leads to a pre-registration year. That year is a paid job that's not related to the university currently. So our plan is to get you ready for that pre-registration year in the best way possible. So when you initially come to university, at the bottom of this slide here, you can see there's four colored boxes: the science and medicines, chemistry for pharmacists, health, disease and therapeutics, and the professional pharmacist. Now, when you first arrive at pharmacy school, you won't have come across some of the science like pharmaceutics. So you really need to get a grip of that before you can start putting it all together. So we have science and medicines, it's about how you make a medicine. Chemistry, that's about the chemical structure of the drugs and how that can affect the way they work in the body. Health, disease and therapeutics, which is about how drugs work in the body at receptors, but also about body systems and organs, and also how they go wrong and how you can treat them with drugs. And then the professional pharmacist, which is about the clinical aspects of that, and the professionalism, ethics and professional decision making that we have, and also the clinical communications. As you progress through the years, that becomes more and more integrated. And in year four, there's an integrated pharmacy practice module, a large module, where all that's tied together. And we really look at multi-disease patients and the problems that they can have, and applying all that knowledge you've built up over the years from the course and experiential learning. And we also have a research project in year four where you can do a 40 credit project, which can lead to publications, which can go on your CV. We have a professional elective where you can get to choose an area that you're particularly interested in, and a business and enterprise module to help you get some business skills for when you leave university. And we prepare you for research in year three with the research methods module. In year one, we also teach you basic life support, and looking on the right hand side here, you can see placements run throughout the 4 years of the program, and they give you that give you some sort of understanding of why you need to know the stuff you need to know in the course. And also we can bring that experience from placements back into the program. Okay. There is a five-year international program that's very similar to the four-year program. So the first 3 years are identical. In year four, we don't have the project. So the project is in the pre-registration module. So the main difference in the five-year program and the four-year program is that the university owns the pre-registration year, and it's actually a fee attracting year rather than a job with a wage. And so it's normally open to international students, but generally it's pretty much the same apart from the project being moved into year five, because they can do projects on placement. If you need further details about that, it is on the web. Okay. So teaching and assessment. So our teaching, we have quite an eclectic mix. So we have lectures and small group teaching, which in the first couple of years are our main pedagogic sort of way of looking at things. So you might have a series of lectures on a subject, and then you will have small group teaching sessions with about 15 students where you can work in small groups to discuss cases that you've worked on, and there's a facilitator there to help you understand the cases and get that conversation going about the application of the science. Now, lectures are all recorded, and we have handouts. Some of the lectures are interactive and flipped. Things are changing at the moment as we move to a more blended approach of more online teaching. But even as we go forward in the next 3 to 5 years after this period, it's likely that lectures may be more in a more recorded format, online format, and that small group teaching is where we're going to have those meaningful interactions with students. It's a really good way of consolidating the information. We also run practicals where you get to make things, simulations where you get to speak to simulated patients, and you can practice all those difficult conversations in the real world in a safe environment. Placements as well are part of our teaching. So we do have teaching done by clinical experts while on placement, and they're usually one-to-one or one-to-two. So looking at assessments, we are now 50% examination for most modules. Some modules are 100% coursework, but the maximum examinations take up will be 50% going forward. OSC is objective structured clinical examinations. So they're like a role play station, essentially, where you turn up and you have to interact with a patient or take a blood pressure or give an injection or dispense a medicine, etc. So they're more about application of knowledge to a clinical scenario. They are coursework, and they'll be run within the teaching time of the university. Some of the practicals will have write-ups, so there is some writing on the course, and there are some occasional essays around evidence-based medicine, or perhaps writing for a lay audience about a scientific process, or writing a patient information leaflet or public health work. There's also a portfolio that leads directly into your postgraduate continuing professional development you'll have to do for the regulator. Simulated tasks around clinical issues, so writing a report about a medical error that's occurred, like what was the cause of this medication error leading to a patient taking the wrong drug. So the sort of thing you might have to do in the real world. And a project report. Currently it's a project report, but from this year it's changing to a scientific paper. So we've had a number of successive papers published by undergraduate students in their final year as they've left university, which can go on your CV. So we've made the project into an actual scientific paper to facilitate that more easily. Okay, so we have a number of placement partners. We have NHS trusts, we have GP practices, we are our pharmacists in, I think, year three go out with the year one medical students and teach them about medicines within GP practices, local community pharmacy chains, wholesale dealers, and we have these relationships with primary care and specials manufacturers as well. So that's really important to us as a placement providers, and making sure they're really relevant placements as we go forward. And one of our biggest partners is right next door to the medical school, where about half of your teaching will take place. But we have other specialist centres we use throughout the West Midlands, which are mostly easily travelled to by the railway station, which is just off to the left of where we're looking now on this picture. So the university's got really good travel connections as well. Pharmacy research, so we have about 45 doctoral students, and we have significant grant income, and you get to experience that with the fourth year project as well. Some of that's paper-based, sometimes it's in the lab, and there are sometimes summer opportunities where you can do research within the university with the research team as a summer project, if that's what you're interested in. Entry to the University of Birmingham MPharm, and we don't currently interview, unlike many schools of pharmacy. That may change in the future, but currently we have no plans to bring that in. GCSE maths, grade B, grade C, our normal offers AAB, chemistry, one other science, and a third subject from a wide range, but not general studies of critical thinking. So we do have people with history A level, or classics. We've had all sorts of English literature, but not general studies of critical thinking. And equivalent qualifications to these grades are accepted, but for that you need to look at the webpage or speak to the recruitment team. Other entry requirements: satisfactory health declaration, evidence that you've had the appropriate immunisation for when you go on placement. You can be exposed to diseases, but also you can, more importantly, generally, you can expose patients to diseases who are in immunocompromised patients. So we don't want you giving measles to someone with a disease. So the other thing is, as a pharmacy student, when you sign up to a pharmacy program or any healthcare program, there is a code of conduct, and you actually effectively become under the auspices of the pharmacy regulator. So there's a code of conduct you have to sign up to. And there's a satisfactory disclosure and barring service check, so to make sure that you're fit to come on the course. And every year you'd have to give a statement that circumstance has not changed. Okay, personal statements. Try and make it relevant to the application and how your experience directly relates to pharmacy. We're particularly interested in people who not just have good grades at science, but also have communication skills. So if you've got experience in GP surgery or a pharmacy or a dental surgery or a care home or somewhere where you're dealing with patients, that's brilliant. We realise it's not always easy to get that. So if you haven't got that, then there's other aspects of where you've shown leadership, perhaps in academic or non-academic settings, and also things like, even like if you're a barista at a coffee shop and you've got experience of dealing with the public or in any other role that you've done or volunteering, put that in there. We just want to see what you've got in terms of leadership and communication going forward. Okay, so, and here's one of our recent sets of graduates. So if you've got any questions, happy to answer them. Thank you very much.